you believe, then you believe that Jesus Christ is the word of God, right?
Was created by the word of Allah. Clearly Allah explained it, what he means. Look, look, if Allah explained what he meant, you cannot start making up words.
He's explained, he's not making up words. It's the Quran. What the Quran said, I will read
Quran it. Said Allah,
everybody understand English, right?
Brother, do you understand what I said? Allah said clearly, Jesus was created by the word of Allah. Do you understand
and,
that?
And I understand that.
Well, okay, wait, sorry. What is different? Hear me. What is different between something was created by the word of Allah and something is the word of Allah? What is the difference between the two? No, ask him a question now.
Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ said, he that speak what I say, right? He that believe in me, we tell people what I say. Jesus Christ himself said that he is God himself.
Where?
I will show it
in the Quran.
In the Bible.
But we talk about the Quran now. We can go to the Bible. I mean,
you can reference the Bible. I can reference the Bible too.
Okay, no problem. No, but firstly, establish.
Is it true?
That the Quran, no. Effie, let's establish that in the Quran explicitly, clearly said Jesus cannot be God and is not God whatsoever. And okay. Allah, hear me out, Allah explicitly and clearly explained what he meant when he said Jesus was created the word of Allah. Allah's word is Allah's attribute. Yes.
In the Quran.
Which Allah's attribute has not begun.
In the Quran. As I'm standing, you've not at any point in time still substantiated that Surah chapter 3 verse 45. It might be an... that is not the understanding of it.
Well, no,
it might be an old word.
Where is it?
In the sense that the word of truth...
Where it says
that someone got Google it.
Google it.
The word of truth, Quran. Jesus Christ was known as the word of truth in the Quran. I'm speaking to you because I've read the whole 140 surahs. So you can speak in Arabic and whatever.
No, but even that verse you mentioned about he's distinguished. Yes, he's distinguished and he's with the prophets and messengers.
It's clear. So he's a clear English.
Yeah, but with the prophets and messengers. It doesn't make him special here.
So
he just was distinguished amongst his people. That's it.
He said in this world, who are those near? That's why I asked you the question. Who are those nearer to Allah in the afterworld?
I said,
the angels.
No, the prophets as well. And the martyrs as well.
And he said,
martyrs.
Jesus would be more distinguished than them.
No, say, Waji and Indallah.
Listen.
Listen. First, the Quran was not translated, was not written in English. So, understand that. That's why we are in a better position than the Christians. Because the Christian, they cannot really say exactly what Jesus said. Because Jesus never spoke English. Hear me out. As for us, we can check out any translation by going back to the origin. Words of Allah, which is Arabic.
Truth. If you can speak in Arabic, does not clarify the truth.
Jesus Christ spoke
in Arabic.
That's what Hashim Uktu
and like Muhammad, Jesus Christ never wrote any words down. It was his companion that wrote words down. The companion, the eyewitness. And I rather believe what an eyewitness wrote than to believe a book that came 7th century. After.
Peter
was an eyewitness.
No, wait.
Matthew was there, the tax collector.
Luke was the eyewitness.
I'm not talking about Luke. I'm talking about
an eyewitness. So do you accept what Luke said?
So what?
No, wait. Do you accept what Luke said?
No, listen to me.
No, answer my question.
Do you believe them or not?
Wait. Not every eyewitness. Some of them are liars. Okay.
They are all liars.
Some of them are liars. Firstly,
what? If they are all liars, then the Sahabas are all liars.
No, it's not the same. Do you accept what Luke said? What Luke said? Do you accept it?
Look, anybody can choose to write.
Now, I ask you that. My question...
Luke was a scholar. Listen.
I didn't say he was a baker.
Luke,
I'm asking you, do you accept what he said?
And there are a lot of scholars who wrote... There are a lot of scholars who wrote the scriptures.
That's not my question. Do you accept what Luke said?
Definitely, if he made...
But he was not eyewitness.
It was not eyewitness.
So why you said no, wait. You said I accept only what the eyewitness said.
But what Luke said, does it contradict the eyewitness?
Of course, you haven't read the Bible, okay. According to Luke, what Jesus said before he died, according to Luke.
I wouldn't know that, but show me one.
Now I'm going to show you. So according to Mark, before Jesus died, according to belief, he said, my God, my God, why you have forsaken me? That's it, full stop. Now when you come to Luke added by saying, Jesus looked at them and he said, God forgive them. Hold a minute, Luke is an eyewitness and he adds something which is not in Mark. And it is not amongst Christian scholars, the first one who was written from the Gospels was Mark.
I've listened to all this that you people have been claiming for all long time. See, we are all here today. Let us be sincere with ourselves, every one of us here, right? We are all eyewitness to the fact that I am Chamsi. We are talking. Sorry if I don't pronounce
it. Brother, I showed you, look, it's added, which is on mark.
If you are here now, right? The way you will write, if I ask you to write what is going on here, the way you will write will be different to the way you will write it. Will be different to the way we are writing. But the fact is that, it will be tailored towards what really materialized. Do you accept, yes or no?
Say again?
If I ask you to write what is going on here today, the way you hold this bottle, the man seeing it, that man now, looking at his phone, to describe you, will describe that you are holding that bottle and he can only see this drink. And this man, we explain this bottle that you are holding in a different way, because everybody will see it from different perspectives, right? So there can be some different variants in what everybody's wrote. The way I write things will be different to the way you write it, but the message is what is important. What does the message deliver?
Okay, the message was Jesus.
Did you accept, yes or no?
I tell you, it's not like that, because if it's the word of God, the word of God has to be same.
No,
this is not a book of history.
Yes or no?
Listen, I don't accept if it's the word of God. If these people are supposed to be writing the word of God, which is...
Let me hear me out.
If they are inspired by God, and firstly, let us go back to the main point, because you said as long as the message is the same.
My point here is,
firstly, let us go back to the main point. The main point clearly I've demonstrated from the Quran, Jesus cannot be God. I'll tell you why. Okay, according to Jesus, who is the only true God?
Sorry. Before you go further, can you define what God is?
God is the creator of the heavens and the earth and that which is between them.
There you go.
Who possesses? Let me finish. Who has no beginning, no end, who possesses, who is eternally perfect.
Did you see where everybody...
Let me finish.
Shamsi, everybody...
Bro, no, brother. Let me finish.
Go ahead.
Who is eternally perfect in his names, in his essence, in his attributes, in his actions. That does not apply to Jesus in whatsoever. Now you dodge my question. Who is the only true God according to Jesus?
First of all, we are wrong according to the definition.
Nah, come on.
No, answer. He has answered. I have a question. Wait. Listen, can you just listen? You cannot intimidate me. Ask a question. I ask, who is God? I mean, what is God? He divine it. Then
I ask you a question.
Reciprocate. If what he divine is true or not.
Okay, go on. Let him speak.
What he divine, according to the context of G-O-D, God, is not what God is. And that is the mistake of everybody. The mistake of everybody, they commit fallacy due to generalization. Now, God...
Let him finish.
So, God himself, G-O-D, is a word, an English word, a coin from a coin English word, which was translated from the Hebrew word that means Elohim, or in the plural form, Eloha. It means someone who has power and authority. Someone who has power and authority.
Huh?
I'm not talking about Almighty God. We will get there.
I'm talking about God.
That's why I said they commit.
That's why Hashem
fallacy.
Left. That's why Hashem ran the
skin. They commit fallacy.
If you know, I forget this.
See, Hashem,
why run away?
Who is God? What is God? That definition of God. They will be telling you about Almighty God. Of course, I know whatever he's saying.
So that's what I'm talking about.
Almighty God.
Huh? So you agree with what
he said?
I agree that Almighty God. But
that's what I'm talking about.
That is not God.
Yeah, but I'm not talking about something else. I'm talking about God. Elena. Effie.
Maybe it's easier for us to understand you. If you agree,
so
yeah.
Understand me.
But if you explain something,
I asked the definition of God. That's what I asked.
And he gave
I didn't ask
I'll give you.
God.
You see.
It's wrong.
Yeah. In the sense that, listen, ask me now, why is it wrong? Why is it wrong, is this? The word God is nobody's name. It's a letter, G-O-D. English words, God is an English word, and it was coined from God, G-O-T-T, from German, a German language.
Yeah.
Now, the word has its root origin from Elohim, which is an Hebrew word that is pluralized to be Eloha.
Who is Eloha?
A plural form of Elohim.
Who is he?
So, Elohim now means someone who has power and authority. Listen, follow me accordingly. Someone who has power and authority. So anyone who has power and authority, according to the simple definition of God, I'm not talking in the context of Almighty God. According to the simple definition of God, anybody who has power, that is why you have God of iron, God of the sea, God of thunder, and Moses was also called God.
Was called Elohim, true.
Yeah,
God to Elohim to Pharaoh.
God to Pharaoh.
Yeah.
That was why Jesus Christ said to those in authority there, that don't you know that ye are called gods, referring to the book of Isaiah, Isaiah. So God, in the context of definition, G-O-D means someone who has power and authority. Yes or no?
Okay. Now this. Wait.
Yes.
Yeah. Wait. No. Let's.
You
go with my mouth.
Wait. But we have.
No. Brother, are you answering my behalf? And you carry on.
This sounds like a
lecture. Brother, it's a lecture now. How long have you been speaking?
Did you agree?
No. It's my time to speak. Now look, you know the Christians, when they cannot answer simple question, when they ask, what is the meaning of Adam? What is the meaning of Jesus? Okay. If I don't know the meaning of Jesus, does not negate Jesus cannot be God. Regardless, what I know. Okay. God will not ask you on the day of resurrection if you know the meaning of Jesus. God will ask you, did you worship the true God, the one who deserves to be worshipped, or you worshipped the false gods? Okay? Now when you ask me the question, you should be more specific. Because you said, who is God? We're talking about, you are a Christian, I'm a Muslim. No. So therefore, let me speak. That's what I'm saying. So you're talking about God? We're a Christian and Muslim, of course. We're not going to be talking about the Greek of God, God of Greek, or the God of the Egyptians. We're going to be talking about the God who created us and created everything. Now, let us go back to the main point. Simple. Is Jesus the true, the only God that deserves to be worshipped alone?
So, I will answer it my own way. So, for we to understand the concept, what is God? Is it yes or no? Someone who has power and authority according to that definition. Before I proceed, yes or no?
I don't agree with this term. This English term, if this English term, that you means God, someone who has a power and authority.
According to Hebrew words, Elohim.
I know, Jesus, because Moses was called Elohim. I understand
yes.
that. Okay.
So,
No, but I'm asking, listen, what I'm asking you. I'm asking you a simple question. Is Jesus, okay. Now you said God, the one who has the power and authority.
Yeah.
Okay. Jesus didn't have power and authority. It was given to him.
That make him God.
But it was given to him.
It was given to him. I will come to that. It was given to him. Moses was made God. The power was given to Moses. Yes or no?
Huh?
Moses that was made God.
Yeah, that's good. Moses was given.
The power was given to him. Yes or no?
So that's true. Moses like Jesus, the prophet.
So Jesus.
Thank you for helping us.
Now,
God doesn't mean that.
Jesus was God. And the power was given to him. Yes or no?
Power was given to him, but it's not God that I believe, like the Creator. No. According to your definition,
he's a God.
Yeah, okay. According to definition,
if you believe Moses was a God at that point,
I don't
time,
believe.
God made
okay,
him God.
Me, okay. You
believe Jesus Christ is a
bro,
God? Yes or no?
Okay. If according to definition, God mean
which
is
be logical.
I'm not finished. Me. According to your definition, because you cannot impose your definition on me.
Shamsi,
I mean, no, let me finish, Shamsi, brother.
I believe you.
But let me speak. How are you gonna believe me?
Listen.
It's not
listen,
let me speak.
What you are saying, I know.
Okay. Let me ask you. No, wait. Is Jesus the one who is perfect all the time?
So that is the question. Let me go to answer his question now.
Okay, it's Ajib, you know.
Jesus Christ is God, right?
Which God? Like Moses?
Jesus Christ is not. Listen.
Yeah. Because that's why you have to pin them down. You see, when you don't cut them, we'll never answer. That's why you pin them down. So people don't say Shamsi, don't cut people.
You cannot pin me down because
okay.
I know what I'm saying.
Okay, now, is Jesus the perfect, Jesus perfect all the times? Okay, you know the Father.
Yeah.
Is the Father power, is the Father God?
The Father is God.
Okay, was but, the power, listen. Was the power given to him?
That is what I'm explaining.
Okay, who's the power given to him?
Explain.
No, okay, who's the power given to him?
So, Jesus.
No, I'm asking, who's the power given to his Father?
I want to explain what you just told me.
What did I tell you?
Can I answer it in my
What did I tell you, Afi? What did I tell you?
He said, is the Father giving the power?
Did someone give Father
power? No, the Father, listen. Jesus Christ, have you accepted his God? Yes or no?
Yeah, like Moses, yeah.
The question
Do you accept Moses as God?
Moses was made God.
But Jesus was made God according to you.
Jesus was also made God.
So you cannot. Look, Alfie, we're not talking about someone who was made God because that cannot be the God that we're talking about. I'm talking who created the universe and everything.
100% Jesus is God, yes or no?
According to you, God means a prophet, okay? That's what he means.
God means someone who has power and authority.
Who is given? Who is
Elohim
given?
And Eloha.
He was
that
given.
That's why anybody can be called God who has power.
That's it. That's according
the
to
queen,
you.
The queen has power. Because she's before God does not mean that she's divine. According to the definition of God.
I'm sweating, man.
People laugh.
Okay, no, I agree. So, we agree with you. We agree. According to your definition, then, yes, so sir. Therefore.
So now, the question is, if Jesus Christ is God, which God?
So,
the question you are now asking is that if Jesus Christ is God, then which God is he? So Jesus Christ is God.
I'm here, I'm not there.
He's not the Almighty God.
It's not
Jesus
Almighty
Christ
God.
Is God, but it's not the Almighty God, the creator of the universe that he was trying to explain. That's why I said some people, they do mistake because they commit fallacy due to generalization.
Okay, so
you have to understand the meaning.
So now, okay, now simple, look, all that time, so therefore Jesus is not the Almighty God.
Jesus Christ
is not the Almighty God.
Wasn't the Almighty God?
Okay, that's
according to the Bible.
Okay, no problem. So okay, now
he is God, 100%. Okay,
him and Moses are same.
He and Moses. He's superior than Moses, as your Quran said.
No, I'm not asking you that. Allah spoke to Moses directly, okay?
Yes.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Moses that he's closer to him. Moses, well, closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So firstly,
he was a prophet.
So Jesus and Moses are same.
They were prophets.
They were God as well. God means they were given power and authority.
Jesus was given power and authority.
Likewise, Moses. Okay, Abraham.
Do you accept that?
According to definition, I accept that. Yeah.
No, not my definition. Do you accept that?
Yeah, but not absolute power. Not absolute power. Do you agree?
Absolute power.
Yeah,
do you accept that?
Yeah, of
course. I will explain.
According to definition, Prophet Muhammad was God.
Yes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
He was, according to that definition of
yeah,
God.
Yeah, I understand that. I understand that. I understand that. But now what we're talking about, that Jesus
yeah.
is not the Almighty God.
He's not the Almighty Father.
Okay, no problem. So now you believe in, do you pray to Jesus?
I pray to Jesus and I pray to God Almighty.
Okay, did Jesus pray to himself or pray to the Father?
That is why I'm asking you, that is it divine or not?
No, I'm asking you, did Jesus pray to himself or to the Father?
Jesus Christ said, do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I'm asking
and
you.
And I don't think you people believe.
I believe in Jesus Christ.
If you believe in Jesus Christ, he said, you believe in what I say. Right?
Did Jesus pray to himself or to the Father?
You asked me if I prayed to Jesus Christ.
No, I didn't ask you. No. Did Jesus pray to himself or he prayed to the Father?
He prayed to the Father, of course.
Okay. So do you follow Jesus?
See, I don't lie. That is the truth.
Do you follow? That's good. Don't lie. Alfie.
That is the truth.
Alfie, that's it.
Jesus Christ prayed to the Father. Does not mean that is not God.
May Ivem Shahi. Alfie. So do you follow Jesus?
I follow Jesus, definitely.
So pray to the Father. Pray to God who created Jesus, the Almighty. Don't pray
to
Jesus.
What? You know what? Jesus Christ said, anything you want to ask, in his statement, he said, ask in my name, and I shall give it to you. Because of the fact that, because of his uniqueness, uniqueness in the sense that the Godship that he belongs to, he was
where Jesus said that? God. Okay, where Jesus said that? Where Jesus said that?
Jesus Christ was known as Mighty God.
No.
Believe that?
He's Almighty God.
He was not as mighty God, not almighty. Almighty is different.
I don't know, this guy. No, Hashim, I know, Lashim, no, brother. That's good. Wait. Alfie, where Jesus said, pray in my name? Where Jesus said that?
Jesus Christ said, ask in my name.
Yeah,
where, and I'll give it to you.
Where he said that?
Matthew 7, that if you ask, and it shall be given unto you. Knock, and it shall be opened.
Yeah, when he said, when he prayed to the Father, pray in my name. Where he said that?
So, if I show you the statement of Jesus about this, are you going to believe it or not?
No, I don't believe it because I don't believe in the Bible.
So why should I show you?
I want to see it.
For purposes of seeing.
Yeah, no, because this is the first time someone caught it. I want to see it. It's the first time. Yeah, I want to see it. We just said when you pray or ask the Father, ask in my name. I just want to see it. Because I know Jesus prayed when he was teaching, he said, oh, our Father in heaven. That's when he prayed to God. He went to what is God?
Yeah, for you to understand that, you have to know what God is.
No, but we're talking about Almighty God. You're different than Christians here. You are different than Christians here.
So,
you're different than the Christians. What Christian are you?
It's not a matter of Christian, it's a matter of the truth.
No, he's different than Christian because Bob and other rest of Christians, they will not be happy with your definition. That you're claiming Jesus only.
I don't care whoever.
That's true because it's true.
It's the truth.
Okay.
Jesus Christ never claimed equality with God Almighty.
That's true. Alhamdulillah.
But the Father is God. He said, all power has been given unto me according to the book of Matthew chapter 28, verse 18.
Okay, show us.
So pray in my name. Let me Google it. And I will do whatever you ask in my name.
No,
talking to his disciples.
That's not Matthew, that's John, first of all.
Yeah.
Okay.
I said Jesus Christ
okay.
said it. Have you seen it?
Wait. You know John, even the Christian scholars will tell you when you read the Bible, when
it's one of the eyewitnesses.
John is not. No, John is not.
He's not the apostles.
I'm talking about John's gospel. He's not eyewitness.
He is.
He's not. He's not. I will substantiate my proof, obviously.
He's right.
Allow me to finish. I will speak. Let me to finish.
So what are you?
Allow me to finish, firstly. Firstly, if you read the Bible,
make it clear which is wrong.
Allow me to. I'm going to substantiate my proof. Let me finish. If you read the Bible, Christian scholars will tell you, by the time you come to John, you see Jesus start becoming God, according to John. All that statement, I and the Father are one, is in John. Whoever see me as in the Father is in John, okay? Before Abraham was I am is in John, okay? Clearly, bear in mind, John is the last gospel that was written, okay? Now, shall I substantiate to you that John's gospel was not written by eyewitness. Go to John's gospel, the end. Let me finish. Go to the end of John's gospel. Go to the end of John's gospel. Go to the end. I'll show you what he says.
You can take the Bible. My phone is 15%.
Go to the end of John's gospel. Go to the end of John's gospel. Anyway, I will quote it by the time again. The end of John's gospel, he says, these are the statements of the disciple. Okay? And we testify. Hold on a minute. These are the statement of the disciple. And we, someone that is writing this gospel, is other than the disciple. It's someone else called we. And who is we? Come.
John.
I believe it's John here, the end of John. Not Matthew, it's the end of John.
So it's part of
a. I believe John, not
Matthew. He's an eyewitness.
John is not eyewitness. What country you from, Ivy? What country you from?
Nigeria.
We beat you, alhamdulillah.
I'm a nurse.
We beat you in football, we're going to beat you in debate.
I'm a nurse anyway. I was discussing with my nurses yesterday. They said, who did I discuss? I said, I discussed Ashim.
Who said to you?
Ashim. Then the nurse said, no, you need to go and discuss Shamsi. That is the only one that he was. I mean, she was.
No, I have to say, Hashim is, mashallah, knows. So, especially when he comes out of Trinity.
Hashim is running away.
And the Bible.
I'm saying it now.
He knows.
Hashim is running away.
I don't believe Hashim is on the way. Alfie, no. Hashim doesn't
know
the way.
He made me confused last week.
Yeah, but that's why.
I came here because of that. Let me establish my point.
Alfie.
13,000 people.
You have to go, Alfie. You have to go?
See, 30,000 people.
Alfie, listen. Before you go, you have to go, yes? You have to go. Yeah. So now, before you go. I don't have to wear a mask. Before Alfie, let me answer to you. Where are the hospital?
No, I work in hospital, yeah.
You work in hospital? You stole them?
We all work in hospital. We all do.
It's good to sometimes joke with the brothers and that. You know, alhamdulillah. Anyway, what Alfie was saying? Alfie, listen. They say, don't spray it.
You don't see. You
Alfie,
are all good at that.
Alfie, listen to
you
me.
You don't just have to insult people
Alfie,
because you are...
Yeah, no, I'm joking with you, Alfie. You're a good guy, inshallah, you know. We pray that Allah guide you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listen, Alfie. When Uthman wrote the manuscript, because the Quran already we have in our tradition was reviewed in a different way of reciting, okay? So listen carefully, yeah? So now he wrote it in the manuscript. Do you know when he wrote it in the manuscript? In a book, do you know what he did? With every book, he sent the reciter to teach, because the Quran cannot be, that's what they say. In Islam, we have a saying. Say, do not learn the Quran from someone who only learned the Quran from the book. No, you have to learn from the scholar who took it from another scholar, because there's a way to pronounce some words. The way it's been written, a different way how to pronounce it, okay? What you have to understand, Alfie, we don't rely on the manuscript, but you rely on the manuscript. So what I would teach you study, Bart Ehrman. Do you know Bart Ehrman?
You might take me away for that.
Okay, Bart Ehrman, he was a Christian scholar. Then he left Christianity. He became agnostic, okay?
And I don't believe in any Christian scholar.
There are experts in manuscripts. They study manuscripts, when it's backdated and everything, yeah? So, inshallah, next week, inshallah, we come back and we talk about it. Take care of yourself. Look, where we pray? Let us pray to the God of Abraham, the God of Moses, the Almighty God. The Almighty God to us. Pray to guide us to the truth.
See,
okay?
Upon all, no matter everything that we say here today,
yeah.
We shouldn't say this one is bigger and bigger or this one is bigger.
Which bigger?
God said that I will have mercy upon whom I will have mercy on. That is what he said.
It's true, it's true. Like, no matter that's who why, that's why, you know, that's why, you know. No, you know, Alfie, that's when Islam, we're not allowed to say, this person, he's going to have fire. Because only only Allah knows who's going to go to have fire, go to paradise. That's it, yeah. But we know, of course, without any doubt, Muslim will go to Jannah, paradise. We know that.
Where?
That's so without any doubt.
You just contradicted yourself.
No, I'm not contradicting myself. Because why? No, Alfie,
because
I'm not.
You don't know for sure.
I'll tell you why. Because Allah said, Muslim, listen, Allah said, Muslim will go to paradise. However, Muslim can leave Islam. You never know. And a non-Muslim can become a Muslim.
So how do you know? You don't know.
No, but Muslim will enter. Muslim is a name for a type. Yeah. Okay, anyway, take care of yourself.
Submission to Allah.
Okay.
But
take care of yourself. Khalas, Khoya.